The moment you read in the paper that Billy Graham is dead, you'll know that he's more alive than he's ever been before, and I'm in paradise. And I'm looking forward to it.
The mark he made for the gospel, for the good news, for Jesus, is unprecedented. What a life. What a life well lived.
Well, he was one of the most important Christian evangelists who ever drew breath.
Now, you can't change your past, but Christ can change your past.
I can only imagine.
God, I'm certain, is with me. And when I come to the moment of death, I believe that at that moment, there's going to be an angel that will take me by the hand and usher me into the presence of the Lord.
What it will be like.
And I'm going to be in His presence, and it's going to be the most peaceful, the most wonderful, the most thrilling moment
when I walk
that I have ever experienced.
By your side.
God has sent me out as a warrior.
I can only imagine.
On the five continents to preach the gospel.
What my eyes will see when your face.
That's the way to God, is through Jesus.
Is before me. I can only imagine.
When you go home tonight, you don't go alone. Christ goes with you. He loves you.
Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus? Or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence? Or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. I can only imagine.
I think he's part of our history. He was the spiritual conscience of our country.
Thank you for the integrity of a man who backed it up in every kind of a way.
Let's talk about 9/11 first. 2001, you're in the White House. What happened, Carl?
Well, Tim Gagline and Matt Smith, two of my deputies, were in charge of the service at the National Cathedral, and they suggested that Billy Graham be asked to participate, and he readily agreed. The difficulty was we had to get him to Washington, D.C., and on that morning of that service, one civilian aircraft was in the skies above the United States.
We should remind everybody that aircraft had been grounded all across the country at that point.
One civilian aircraft is in the skies above the United States, and it bears Billy Graham.
He died on the cross so that all the sins you've ever committed, all the things you've ever done wrong, are forgiven. What do you have to do? You have to repent of your sins.
I can only imagine when that day comes and I find myself standing in the sun. I can only imagine when all I will do is forever, forever worship you. I can only imagine.
This is a joyful, godly man. I want to just say thank you, God.
I can only imagine
that you blessed this generation with a man whose heart was sold out to you.
Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus? Or in all of you be still, will I stand in your presence? Or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. I can only imagine. To my knees.
speak of the advancement of the gospel in the U.S. without the name Billy Graham coming up.
He didn't stop with his generation.
I can only imagine when all I would do is forever, forever worship you.
There's been nobody like this man, probably ever in the history of mankind. And to watch people respond to the message, pretty overwhelming every single night.
I can only imagine.
I would like to be remembered as a person who was faithful to God and faithful to my call and did it with integrity and with love.
I'm going to ask you to do something that we've seen thousands of people do all over the world. I'm going to ask you to make a commitment tonight to be sure that you know Christ and that you're ready for eternity.